Okay, now we've let this set and the glue has now set on this. So now we're going to undo the string and just reveal just how good a fit we've got all the way around. It's always a little bit exciting doing this because you hope you've managed to squash it all up nice and tight and everything's held in place. I'll take this away. And this small piece I put on the top here is just in case any glue comes out, it'll stick to this. I put it face down to face side, or face to face. So again, the white bar, will be, if there is any glue, will be peel off and sort of all disguise it. Now there is a tiny little overlap here. It wasn't completely flush, so I need to trim that little bit away. Which is a bit of a shame, but oh, it's millimetres. So very carefully, I just want to cut. I'll tell you what I'll do, we'll trim this up and then I'll get that sorted out. So first things first, down the bottom here, I just need to trim off all this excess here. So I'm not sure what shadow you're going to get in. Let's see if I can turn this light around a bit. So we can improve the lighting for you. Is that better? Yep. So I'm going to trim this away here. So I just start where the join is. And then just start cutting in. Now initially my first cut is just to get into it, and then I'll come round and just tidy up. To get a nice straight line. So what I've got now, okay, you can see, because there is a slight chamfer on the edge of the flask anyway, so I just take it down to the edge of the chamfer, gives you a nice finish on the bottom, and something nice and flat for it to sit on. So I'll do the same for the top, just trim the top now. nearly finished. What we need to do now is clean up this outer bark. That up here, there's some bits that are rough, sticky out bits, and then we need to sand it and smooth it. So what I'm going to do is similar to what I did with the front. It's just these bits that are sticking out and a bit proud, just nice and gently, just ease them off. And then we can just then set about sanding this smooth. So basically, this is our flask finished. You see how much nicer it looks having this bark on it. Now I'm going to oil this, and this will really bring the colours out. But before I do that, I just want to put a little mark down here. Okay, so that's my mark. That's like my signature or just my initials, just my mark. And then I'm gonna oil this up. And the oil I'm gonna use is this, okay? It's tung oil. It's suitable for food services, interior and exterior use. It's a pure natural oil for wood. So now's the moment of truth to see just how nice this will look when this colour comes out. And I find I can never be 100% sure until I get the oil on. But let's see what happens. So it's going to take a few coats of oil to soak in, and what will happen is these little bits of bark will start to flake off in time, and you will start to get this contrast in it from where it's been oiled. I mean, the oil will soak in to a certain extent, but then these will start to peel off and you'll start to get this. See the contrast of the white underneath it? These will start to come out more and more. So I'll pull another one off. There you go. And you can see that you'll start getting that really pretty effect on the bark. So it'll always keep changing the way its appearance and how it looks. Obviously I can exaggerate it a little bit by starting this off. But I don't want too much to come off to start with, because I want it to, you know, change and improve with age. So I'm going to leave that to soak, for that oil to soak in, and then buff it and give it a few coats, and then oil it and buff it in a few coats, and I'll do that if quite a few times, get the layers on it, and then I'll come back and show you the finished article. Now, what I do like about this particular, this project, I mean, one, you get something that's very distinctive, very unique, and I think very attractive. I really like them. But the great thing about these, they're simple to make. So, you know, if you're one of my younger subscribers and you're looking for a project, you know, to make for your dad for his birthday or Christmas or something, you could do this yourself. You don't even have to use a knife. You know, you can cut birch bark with a pair of scissors. The glue, you may, depend on how young you are, okay, you may not be allowed to use a glue or buy the glue yourself, but I'm sure, you know, someone could help you out. But this is a really good project for anybody to make. You know, it's not age restrictive. A lot of these projects you see us do, you know, are fairly quite technical. Some of them are quite technical and involve using, you know, either sharp knives or power tools. But this one, I think anyone could have a go at making this. So, yeah, give it a go. It's a really nice project. And I don't know about you, but you know, it's something, you know, this is cheap. You know, the bark I got from a freshly cut down birch tree. I don't like cutting, or I don't take bark off standing trees. But this was freshly down and it was a little bit dried out. It'd been down a few weeks, okay, so it's a bit harder to peel off. But if it's freshly cut, it should be really easy to peel these off, okay? But take your time, peel the bark. If you're really young and you want to do this as a project, you may need to get somebody to help you to get the bark, but I'm sure you can find someone who can get it for you. But it's a really great project, and if you don't want to use bark, why not get some leather, you know, wrap it in a piece of leather, or a piece of hide or something like that. You know, a leather coated one would be lovely, and it's just a really nice simple project. Now there is one other little modification I'm going to make to this, because I'm making this for someone very special to me. It's a very good dear friend of mine, so I'm going to do one other modification to this, and it's going to be to this lid. Okay, so I'll when I've got that sorted out, I'll come back and I'll show you the tweak on the lid, the modification to the lid. But yeah, this is a personal gift that I'm making to somebody, and you know, it is cheap to make. No lying, you know, it cost me hardly anything to make this. But it's something about a gift that's been made as opposed to something that's been bought. You know, I could have, or anybody could go out and buy something. If you've got the means to pay for it, you can buy it. But I don't know, sitting down and taking the time to actually make something, yeah, it's very special. So, and this flask, I know for a fact, is going to contain cognac. So I'm pretty sure by me saying that, my friend who will probably know who he is. So yeah, so there's going to be a really nice cognac in here. Right, so thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next video. Thanks for all your support and your comments. And you know, if you ever go doing something like this, you know, please post it as a video response or send me a photo or something of it so I can see what you get up to. What I get amazed by is, you know, I make these sort of ideas, and mine are all very simple ideas. And then, you know, my subscribers come along and far more artisans than me. Okay, they're much more creative. far more skilled in their crafts, and they come up with some fantastic variations on the ideas that I've come up with. So I'm looking forward to seeing what you can come up with. See you soon.